morning children. This is for grade 8 session 15 mathematics. Now in session 14 already we have dealt with chapter 2 linear equations in one variable exercise 2.2. First and second sum we have completed. Now we are going to start with the third sum. Listen the question carefully. The base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 cm. The perimeter of the triangle is 4 2 by 15 cm. What is the length of the either of the remaining equal sides? Now we are going to find out the perimeter of an isosceles triangle. What is the meaning of perimeter? Perimeter means adding the boundaries. Okay. Now what is the meaning of isosceles triangle? Two equal sides. Triangle which have two equal sides and one side different is called isosceles triangle, right? So base of an isosceles triangle is given. What is the base of the isosceles triangle? 4 by 3 cm. 4 by 3 cm is the base of the isosceles triangle, it is given, and the perimeter of the whole triangle, isosceles triangle, is given as 4, 2 by 15 cm. This is the two things which is given in your book. Perimeter means it is adding the boundaries. So base of the isosceles triangle is given 4 by 3 cm and the perimeter of the whole isosceles triangle is given 4, 2 by 15 cm. Now you are supposed to find what is the length of either of the remaining equal sides. You are going to find out the either of the remaining equal sides. So I don't know these two sides. Let me keep that sides as x. Can you understand? So these two sides will be x. Now, solution. First let us convert the 4 2 by 15 into the improper fraction. It is a mixed fraction. Let us convert to improper fraction. What is 15 into 4? 4 5 is 20, 2 carry over, 4 1 is 4, 4 plus 2 6, 60. 60 plus 2, this 2 you have to multiply and you have to add the numerator. So 60 plus 2 is 62 by 15 cm. Okay, now perimeter means you know you have to add all the 3 sides. So what is the first side? Perimeter is x is x plus x, 2 sides, x plus 4 by 3. Centimeter, which is equal to 62 by 15. This is the perimeter. This is the formula. Side 1 plus side 2 plus side 3 is equal to what number is given. It is taken. Okay, this is the format what you have got. Now you are going to solve and find out the x value. Okay, now x plus x is 2x plus 4 by 3, which is equal to 62 by 15. Now let us take this 4 by 3 to RHS. So the sign will change. So 2x is equal to 62 by 15 minus, this plus will become minus 4 by 3. Now take LCM for 15 and 3. Take 3, 5 3 is 15, 1 3 is 3, 5, 1 5 is 5 and 1. So 3 5 is 15. Your LCM is 3 5 is 15. Now here it is already 15, so you have to multiply only with 1. So if you multiply 62 into 1, you have the same number 62. And here you have 3. 3 into 5 is 15. Because your LCM is 15, so multiply by 5 on both numerator and denominator. So 4 into 5 will be 20. The symbol given here is subtraction. So 20. So 62 minus 20 is equal to 42 by 15. What is 42 by 15? 2x is equal to 42 by 15. 2x is equal to 42 by 15. Now you are going to find out the x value. Now this 2 is in the multiplication. If it goes to right hand side, it will become division. So x is equal to 42 by 15 into 2. What is 15 into 2? 15 into 2 is 30. So 42 divided by 30. In which table 42 and 30 you will get? You will get in 6th table. So x is equal to 42, 7 times 5, 6 5 is 30. So your answer will be 7 by 5. Now if you want you can leave as such, otherwise you can convert to mixed fraction. How you will convert to mixed fraction? 7 divided by 5, 1 5 is 5. You have remainder 2. Okay, the denominator will be the same, 5, and the quotient will come here and 2. 5 1s are 5, 5 plus 1 is 5 plus 2 is 7. So 7 by by 5. Can you understand? Again, from the first I will tell you, listen. The base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter and the perimeter is 62 by 15 centimeter, which means they have given 4 2 by 15 centimeter. That improper fraction I have converted as that mixed fraction I have converted as the improper fraction, and this is the one. Now perimeter means side plus side plus side. This is base, because it is isosceles triangle, so they have given base. Side plus base is equal to the given number. So x plus x is 2x and the base is 4 by 3, which is equal to 62 by 15. This plus 4 by 3, when I take to the RHS, that is right hand side, it will become minus 4 by 3. So minus 4 by 3 is given. I am going to take LCM for 15 and 3. My LCM is 15. Here for 15, my LCM is 15, so I need not to multiply anything, only 1. So the same number will remain here. But here I have 3. When I multiply with 5 only, it is 15. So 4 into 5 and 3 into 5. Both in the numerator and denominator, you are going to multiply 5. Okay. Now 62 minus 20 by 5 is equal to 42 by 15. Now 2x is equal to 42 by 15 and 2x is equal to 42 by 15. What I have did? This x is, this 2 is in multiplication here. When I take to the opposite side, it will be in division. And x is equal to 42 by 30. This will come at the 6th table. So we have cancelled and we have got 7 by 5. 7 by 5 is an improper fraction, and this improper fraction can be written as a mixed fraction, 1, 2 by 5. Can you understand? Okay, now we will move on to the next sum.
Minus 15.
Now again 2x is equal to 95 minus 15 is 80. Here x into 2. 2x means it is in multiplication. The symbol in between is multiplication. So 2x is equal to 80, which means x is equal to this 2. When it goes to right hand side, it becomes division. So 80 divided by 2, 1 2 is 2 and 4 2s are 8, this 0, 40. This 0 as it is become, it will 40. So 40 into 2, it is equal to 80. X is equal to 40. But my sum will not end here. My question is find the numbers. Only x I have found out, I have to find out the other number, x plus 15. So my first number is x is equal to 40 and my second number is x plus 15 is equal to 40 plus 15, which is equal to 55. So in this session we have dealt third sum and fourth sum. Third sum is regarding perimeter of a isosceles triangle. They have given the base and perimeter of the triangle. You have taken x and x as two sides. You have solved and find out the x value. Now here in this sum they have given the sum of two numbers and one number exceeds the other number by 15. So x and x plus 15, you have solved and found out the two numbers x and x plus 15. So the sum is 40 plus 55, which is equal to 95. It is correct. You can check it in that way. Okay. Now the four sums in x is 2.2. Revise once again at your home so that it will be clear for you. Okay. Thank you.